Cobra 2276 Heavy, wind 360 at 5, runway 7 left at Alpha 8, cleared for takeoff.
Takeoff, 07 left, speedway 2276 Heavy.
Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel and to a great ATC related video, as many of you have questioned, why do pilots say heavy at the end of their call sign, as you just heard in the intro, and what the heavy call sign has to do with roof tiles. So let's get started.
24, it's the captain's last landing in the 76 and he's promised an absolute breezer, so I think we're going to need some scores from the sideline.
Now, I'm pretty sure many of you have seen airplanes approaching airports all lined up like pearls on a necklace, coming in one by one. Now, they seem to be all flying in a safe distance from each other, as this is the work of the approach controller. Now, he makes sure that the airplanes have enough separation from each other by vectoring them with given headings and controlling their speed onto the instrument landing system. Now, the planes land as such that they have enough time to vacate the runway at the suitable taxiway before the next plane comes to land. Now, as you can see here in this video, an Airbus A320 is just landing and you can already spot the next airplane, a Boeing 777, right behind it. But the reason for this separation is not just the time to vacate the runway, actually the primary reason is wake turbulence avoidance. So what is a wake turbulence? Now, a wake turbulence or wing vortex occurs when wing is generating lift. Now, if air below the wing is drawn around the wingtip into the region above the wing by the lower pressure on the upper side of the wing, causing a vortex to trail from each wingtip. Now, the strength of the wingtip vortex is determined primarily by the weight, the airspeed, and the angle of attack of the aircraft. Now, the higher the angle of attack and the heavier the plane, the stronger the wake turbulence becomes. Now, this short video here perfectly shows the generation of wake turbulence, but keep in mind, this is only an ultralight airplane with a maximum weight of roughly 450 kilos, but it's impressive how quickly the wakes appear. So imagine the wake turbulence a Boeing 747 generates with a maximum landing weight of 302 tons. And wake turbulence are a serious threat for the preceding plane. Nasty downdrafts and sudden excessive roll rates get the plane in an upset state you do not want to experience on short final as a pilot nor as a passenger. Numerous testing has shown that wingtip vortices have an estimate sink rate of 400 feet per minute and come to rest at 800 feet below the airplane's flight path, where it is considered safe to fly across the dissipating wake. So let's determine the minimum separation needed between two Airbus A320s. Now, we are definitely going to need 2 minutes, as that is the time it takes to wake to descend 800 feet, and 2 minutes at an average approach speed of 130 knots, results in 4.3 nautical miles minimum separation distance. Now, at 64.5 tons maximum landing weight, the A320 is not the heaviest aircraft out there, so the ICAO came up with the wake turbulence weight categories. Now, write this down because these numbers will be in your ATPL exam. Now, category L is for lightweight, so any plane up to 7 tons or less. Category M for medium is for 7 tons up to 136 tons, and anything heavier than that is categorized as heavy. But as usual, there is an exception, so listen to the ATC call of my dear friend pilot Alexander.
Bucharest Control, very good morning. Qatar 13 Victor Papa Super at level 390.
Now, as he flies the Airbus A380, ICAO had to introduce a new category for aircrafts with a takeoff weight up to 560 tons named Super. So, as mentioned a minute ago, the heavier the plane, the larger and more intense the wakes are, the more separation is needed between the planes. Now, if we come back to our first video, you see the British Airways 777 has just landed, categorized as heavy, followed by a medium category Airbus A320. Now you can see there's a significant larger gap between both airplanes. And as ICAO regulates, if a medium follows a heavy aircraft, the minimum separation has to be 5 nautical miles. Now this can go up to 8 nautical miles, for instance, if a light aircraft like a Cessna Caravan follows an Airbus A380. But if a heavy aircraft follows a lighter aircraft, they aren't affected as much by the wake due to their actual heavier weight and are safe at a distance of 4 nautical miles. But it's not just the ATC controller's responsibility to vector you accordingly. You as a pilot have to keep the necessary distance in order to not get into the wake turbulence of the preceding aircraft. But how do you know as a pilot what type of plane is ahead of you? And this brings us to the main question of the video. That's the reason why pilots flying airplanes categorized as heavy, creating the more severe turbulence, mention their category at the end of their call sign. So as a pilot, you should pay close attention who you're following, especially when intercepting the ILS at a lower altitude than your preceding airplane. And wakes aren't just a threat during landing. A similar procedure applies during takeoff. Now, very often you can see a heavy Airbus A330 departing and then a smaller Boeing 737 or Airbus A320 wait on the runway for their takeoff clearance. Now, the waiting period is a safety measure to let the wake turbulence dissipate before the lighter aircraft commences takeoff. Now, you say that's not true. I've seen turboprops rolling down the runway right after a heavy has taken off. Yes, that's true. This can happen, but there's something very important to keep in mind. Wake turbulence, as mentioned before, are first generated when the plane rotates, meaning creating lift over the wing. So, if the turboprop pilot closely monitored the lift-off point of the preceding plane and knows his takeoff roll will be shorter, he can immediately commence takeoff as he will fly over the flight path and wakes of the preceding plane. Also, during cruise, flying through the contrail of an aircraft can get very turbulent, so avoid flying through those, especially with passengers on board. Now, these strong rotors upon landing are no joke. They are so powerful that houses close to airports have to have special roof tiles, as in the past they have caused many damages. Especially if you're in flight school and feel the need to fly to a big international airport for a low approach with your little Cessna. And besides, the tower controller will warn you about the wakes, keep a safe distance, because getting flipped over by a wake isn't cool at all. And if it doesn't feel safe, you can always go around. Also, be aware of hovering helicopters in the vicinity of the runway. Their wakes can be as powerful as a medium categorized aircraft. And by the way, speaking of flight school, have you ever thought why a glider plane always flies a little higher than its preceding tow plane? Think about it. And as always, Concorde had her own rules, although Concorde fell into the category of a medium weight aircraft due to her excessive angle of attack upon landing. Her delta wing created wake turbulence as strong and as dangerous as the ones of a jumbo, and therefore the pilots had to say Speedbird Concorde 2 heavy. God, I miss this plane. That's it for today. Thank you very much for your time. Perform a touch and go at my Instagram account and mention your wake category. Hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. And don't forget, a good pilot is always learning. See you next week. Wishing you all the best, your Captain Joe.